places where living beings find food, shelter, can reproduce, and can protect themselves are called their habitats. Therefore, the habitat of fish is water, deer is forest, camel is desert, cactus is desert. The animals and plants living in a habitat have certain features that make them well suited to live in their habitat. These features are known as adaptations. Temperature in the hot desert may reach 50 degrees Celsius during daytime. The rainfall is also much less in these areas. Such conditions make survival of plants and animals difficult in the desert. Only those plants and animals that are adapted to conserve water are found in hot deserts. How does cactus survive in desert? It has a succulent stem that stores water. Observe the green color of the stem. The stem has chlorophyll and can carry out photosynthesis. What is the role of spines on the cactus? Spines are modified leaves reduced to spines. Since leaves transpire, and in cactus they are reduced to spines, water loss is reduced. Cactus has a shallow but extensive root system. It enables the plant to readily absorb rainwater before it goes into deeper layers of soil. Kaner or Nerium is also a common desert plant. Have you ever noticed that the leaves are stiff and leathery? This reduces loss of water through transpiration. This is a kaner leaf cut transversely. Note the thick cuticle. It helps in reducing water loss through transpiration. These are stomata. See how these are placed in deep cavities that are crowded with hairs. The cavities and the hair hold water vapor over stomata. As a result, the leaf loses very little water through transpiration. The common desert animals like the desert lizard, desert snake, kangaroo rat, and camel also face less availability of water. Observe carefully the skin of the desert lizard and the desert snake. The skin is scaly. Such a skin prevents water loss from the body. These animals burrow into deeper, cooler sand during daytime. This not only helps in preventing water loss, but also escaping high temperatures. Camels are known as the ships of the desert. They are very adapted to the desert habitat. Nostrils can be closed to prevent entry of sand. Long eyelashes of camel help to protect the eyes from sand. Tongue is enclosed in a thick membrane to minimize water loss by evaporation. The hump has a store of fat. When broken down in the body, releases water and energy. This water can be used up by the body. Thin fur and little fat below the skin allow the loss of heat produced in the body. Its feet are large with membrane between toes. The feet help in walking on sandy surface without sinking into sand. Did you know that camel can drink up to 100 liters of water in 10 minutes when water becomes available? Also, the camels can survive without water for 6 to 8 days. The kangaroo rat does not drink water. It eats dry seeds. Also, it has no sweat glands and excretes concentrated urine. It uses water produced by the breaking down of food in the body. Such water is termed metabolic water. Compare the plants of a desert and a broad-leaved forest and write the differences. We notice that the leaves are large and broad in the plants of a broad-leaved forest. Broad leaves help in maximizing photosynthesis. This is a cross-section of a leaf. Observe that there is a large number of stomata near the surface. These stomata help in exchange of gases. The plants have a deep and well-developed root system which helps in absorbing lot of water. These are coniferous forests of the Himalayan region. The temperature is usually very low in these areas as there is frequent snowfall. These trees have needle-like leaves that help in reduction of water loss and step downward sloping branches. The limbs of animals like deer, nilgai, antelope are adapted to walk and run on firm ground. Deer, antelope, rhinoceros, and horses run on the tip of the toes or hoofs. Tiger and lion are fast runners. They run on their toes or digits. Monkeys walk with the entire sole of the foot touching the ground. Observe carefully the foot of deer, tiger, cat, lion, and monkey. Deer walks and runs on tips of toes or hoofs touching the ground. Hoofed mammals are known as ungulates or they who walk on tips of toes. Lion, tiger, cat, dog walk and run on toes. Toes are known as digits. So animals walking on toes are known as digitigrade. Monkeys are plantigrades as they walk on the entire sole of the foot. Human beings walk on 2 feet. This is called as bipedal locomotion. Bipedal gait has made hands free. Hands can therefore be used to perform many other functions. Lungs of man, birds, and other animals are adapted to use oxygen from the air or for aerial breathing. The heads of snake, shrew, and mole have a common tapering shape. This tapering shape of head helps these animals in digging and burrowing. Some animals, like the flying squirrel, flying lizard, and tree frog, are adapted to fly or glide in air and also to walk on land. Birds and bats are adapted to fly in air. They have wings to fly in the air. Wings of bird and bat are modified forelimbs. Flight muscles provide additional strength for flying. Air cavities in bones make the body light. The light body weight is an adaptation for flight. Animal and plants are well adapted to living in their habitats. Note the adaptations of various plants and animals and discuss them with your friends.